nice.
That's so cool.
I want a bracelet.
My name is Tiffany Yu. I am joining you from Los Angeles, California, and I'm here because I'm a disability advocate, and TikTok changed my life and so many others within the disability community.
What do you do on TikTok?
I make disability advocacy content. I have a series called the Anti-Ableism series where I teach people how to be a better ally to disabled people, and it's got over 5 million views and 250 parts.
Hello, my name is Eamon. I'm from Chicago, and I'm here because I talk about books on TikTok, and I encourage people to read, and I want to keep up doing that.
TikTok has allowed my dreams that I used to have as a child to come true. I would hate the dreams of all of the other people that use the app that are inspired and educated for those dreams to be crushed.
Do you have any concerns about China tapping into people's phones or security risks from China?
Absolutely not. If I had any concerns about China, I would have the same concerns about right here in America sharing and selling our data too.
I run a sticker shop, actually, and my son is a non-speaking autistic artist, and we tuck his designs inside of outlines. I mean, it went viral during the pandemic, and I have another child who had a bone marrow transplant in 2017, so our family had to live in quarantine. So during the pandemic, thanks to that sticker shop, we stayed afloat, and I support a family of seven.
TikTok has done something very amazing for me as far as starting my tax business. When I started it, I put everything into it to the point where I lost everything, to the point where I was living, sleeping out of my truck, filed eviction. I got evicted. I went through bankruptcy. Then all of a sudden when I went on TikTok, it completely changed my life. I went from literally sleeping in my truck to living in a penthouse to now employing people. We have a team of 17 people. We have a staff. It's been so amazing because of the impact of TikTok that I'm able to provide health insurance for my employees' children. And my employees thank me every day, oh my God, this is so amazing. If TikTok was stripped away from small business owners like myself, I'm very afraid to have that difficult conversation that says, hey man, this isn't gonna work out. Hey man, you know, your kids, I can no longer take care of them. So that's what TikTok has done for me, and I'm speaking on behalf of many small business owners that a lot of us would be affected.
You know, I voted no, and the reason I voted no is because of the First Amendment, and I think the courts are going to strike this down. If you look at First Amendment and you look at the scholars, they'll tell you that, first of all, it's not the least restrictive. There are things you could do to protect people's privacy that are the least restrictive. Second, under the Supreme Court, you have a test called, can you have alternative means of communication to get to folks on who are TikTok users. You can't because there are almost a billion people and other social networks won't satisfy that test. Third, we already have a lot of magazines in this country, newspapers that are owned, that are foreign owned. And the Supreme Court has said that Americans have the right to information, even if it's coming from overseas. So it's an overly broad bill that I don't think will withstand First Amendment scrutiny. The other issue is that there are a lot of people who make their livelihoods on this. I mean, in my office yesterday were people who had small businesses, a young African-American gentleman who said he went from living in his truck to living in the penthouse. I said, that's pretty good on TikTok. And he employs now 20 people. So a lot of different people who are in business because of this. But ultimately, it's just a foul of our First Amendment.
I voted yes, and I served on the Intel committee 8 years. I didn't need to be convinced. I have 8 years of experience. I understand why it's important. It's not a First Amendment issue. It's not a shutdown. It's a divestiture. And it's a national security issue.
I think there are serious national security concerns, but I think the way the bill was crafted was problematic. And so I voted no. There are constitutional questions, I think, in the way it was crafted. There are timeline questions. 180 days to sell a company this size is very difficult. What happens to antitrust law? Does it still apply? Does it not apply? And I think, you know, the questions of if this is a de facto ban, I think that is a real problem. And so I also have problems, by the way, four countries are named, but if Saudi Arabia buys it, is that fine? Are we not concerned about the national security concerns in that situation? So I just think it's an important issue. It deserves to be addressed. but I think it should be addressed with more input and more thoughtful deliberation and understanding about how to make sure all these concerns are addressed.
But if Congress wanted to be serious about protecting our national security from China, we would stop China from buying our farmland. We would stop China from investing in our universities. We wouldn't pursue the Green New Deal that forced Americans to drive cars that China owns 85% of the battery market worldwide. So there's many ways to stop China. We would produce our oil and natural gas fossil fuels, and we would dominate China and the world as far as energy is concerned. That's the way you stop China. To say that this is protecting Americans' data is not true. If we wanted to protect Americans' data, we would protect Americans' data universally from any company that takes data and sells their data.
Don't deny that there's trade-offs. But it's not a ban on TikTok. An American investor can, group of investors can buy it, which is, I think, pretty highly likely. ByteDance, in the end, is a company, and they'd be crazy not to sell at what is, I think I've heard, valuations of $100 billion. So I'm not seeing a ton of evidence that they would just, out of principle, refuse to sell. That would be unlikely. In my opinion, but we'll see how it plays out. The priority here, though, is national security, and again, Chinese access to millions of Americans' minds. Like that's what the primary issue is. Is there trade-offs when you deal with an issue like that? Yeah, there's trade-offs.
We are legislating in a new land with respect to apps and social media. So, this is America. Anybody can sue anybody, and so. I wouldn't be surprised if it went to court, and there are issues there. But generally, I think the Congress is stating that the data rights of Americans have got to be safe from foreign government manipulation, and that's part of national security. Wall Street can move quickly, but the question is whether, interestingly, a broader bill would be more narrowly tailored than a bill that's focused on just particular companies in particular countries. So there are legitimate and valid questions about that.
Do you think they're going to be resolved in the Senate?
I think that the Senate will play its classic role of trying to cool things off and figure out maybe a broader way of going about this.